The Boötes Void, also known as the Great Nothing, is one of the loneliest corners of our universe, an extremely vast but almost empty region of space located in the Boötes constellation. With a diameter of 330 million light years, the Great Nothing is about 3,000 times larger than the Milky Way. If we lived at the center of this void, we wouldn't have known that other galaxies exist until the development of powerful telescopes and detectors in the 1960s. So, what lies inside this mysterious supervoid? And what could have emptied such an enormous area of matter? To answer these questions, we should go back in time. In the 17th century, with the advent of telescopes, astronomers like Galileo Galilei discovered that the Milky Way was made up of countless stars. However, they still believed that the Milky Way was the entire universe. It wasn't until Edwin Hubble's discovery that we realized the true scale of the universe, finding that our galaxy is just one among billions. In the 1930s, Fritz Zwicky observed that many galaxies grouped together in clusters. Astronomers began systematically cataloging galaxy clusters, revealing that galaxies are not evenly distributed across the universe, but tend to form large structures. Advances in computer simulations in the late 20th century allowed astronomers to zoom out even further and model the large-scale structure of the universe. These simulations showed that galaxies are not randomly scattered, but instead form a vast cosmic web of filaments, sheets, and nodes, with galaxy clusters located at the intersections. Large-scale studies, like the CFA Redshift Survey, mapped the positions of thousands of galaxies. These surveys provided observational evidence of the cosmic web, revealing a vast network of interconnected galaxies and clusters. As astronomers mapped the cosmic web, they discovered vast empty areas, now known as voids. These regions of space have very few galaxies, usually spanning tens to hundreds of millions of light years in diameter. As more voids were discovered and studied, astronomers identified some extremely large ones, known as supervoids. One of the most significant supervoids, the Boötes Void, was discovered by astronomer Robert Kirschner and his team in 1981. By the way, contrary to popular belief, this image is not the Boötes Void. It's actually Barnard 68, a dark nebula that blocks the light from stars behind it, giving it a distinct dark appearance similar to a void. In other words, this area is not empty. We just can't see the stars behind the nebula. The Boötes Void lies about 700 million light years away, near the Boötes constellation. Spanning about 330 million light years across, this void is approximately 0.27% of the size of the entire observable universe, which itself is 93 billion light years across. This makes Boötes one of the largest voids ever discovered. Despite its vast size, the Boötes Void contains only 60 galaxies, whereas a typical region of space of the same size would contain thousands. Even the galaxies within this supervoid are sparsely populated, being about 1% as dense as the average galaxy found in the rest of the universe. Most of the galaxies inside the Boötes Void are found closer to its edges, at the transition between the void and more densely populated regions of space. The Boötes Void could slowly be getting larger, as galaxies on its edge are pulled into nearby galaxy clusters and filaments. But how did such a giant void form? While the exact cause remains a mystery, there are some reasonable theories. One possible explanation relates to the origin of the universe, specifically during and immediately after the period known as inflation in the Big Bang model. Back then, space wasn't completely smooth. There were tiny, random differences in the amount of energy at different points, what we call quantum fluctuations. The inflation theory suggests that our universe underwent an extremely rapid expansion within a fraction of a second after the Big Bang. During inflation, the universe stretched out very quickly, and these tiny fluctuations in energy were stretched out too, becoming larger differences in the density of matter. Some areas ended up with slightly more matter, and others with slightly less. These differences can be seen in this snapshot of the universe, when it was just 380,000 years old, known as the Cosmic Microwave Background, or CMB. Discovered in 1965, the CMB is the afterglow of the Big Bang, a faint radiation that fills the universe. The cold spots in the CMB, such as this one, represent regions with lower than average density of matter. However, during this time, the variations in densities were extremely small, on the order of one part in 100,000. These small variations were crucial, though, as they were the seeds that eventually grew into the large-scale structures in the universe today. Over billions of years, areas with more matter attracted even more material due to gravity, eventually forming galaxies and clusters of galaxies. Areas with less matter, on the other hand, didn't attract as much material, leading to fewer galaxies and, in some cases, large empty spaces. The Boötes Void is one of these large empty regions. Over billions of years, this underdense region grew into the massive void we see today, where there are very few galaxies compared to other parts of the universe. This process could be intensified by dark energy, a mysterious force that makes up about 68% of the universe and causes it to expand at an accelerating rate. In denser regions, where galaxies and galaxy clusters exist, gravity tries to pull matter together, resisting the expansion. However, in voids, where there is little matter to begin with, there isn't much gravity to resist the expansion caused by dark energy. As a result, voids expand more rapidly, because there is less gravity pulling things together. Thus, dark energy could amplify the formation of voids, leading to supervoids like Boötes. It's also possible that the Boötes Void formed through the merging of smaller voids. As the universe expanded, these smaller voids could have combined into a much larger one. Given the terrifying loneliness of the Boötes Void, some people have speculated about more exotic origins. Some suggest that advanced extraterrestrial civilizations might be responsible for the void. This theory suggests that an advanced civilization might have intentionally cleared out the galaxies within this region, possibly due to large-scale engineering projects, energy harvesting, or even as part of an unknown cosmic-scale experiment. In other words, the lack of galaxies could be interpreted as evidence of a civilization that somehow moved, dismantled, or repurposed entire galaxies. However, the idea that an alien civilization could manipulate or remove entire galaxies on such a massive scale is beyond our current understanding of physics and technology. Plus, there is no empirical evidence supporting this hypothesis, making it a fringe idea rather than a scientifically validated theory. The Boötes Void is extremely distant, and our observations are limited to the light and other electromagnetic signals that reach us. We can't observe the void's formation directly. We only see the end result, an area of space with very few galaxies. Therefore, the formation of large-scale cosmic structures like voids is not fully understood, and accurately simulating them requires highly sophisticated models and computational power.